Hello everyone, Randy here again. We're playing Farming Simulator 15 on Pleasant Valley Rivers on the RDL and multiplayer server. And we are loading up some gypsum at the moment. Going to work on trying to make some drywall here this episode. Yes, folks, you heard me correctly. We're going to try to make some drywall in Farming Simulator. And I think this was the last ingredient we needed. Double check here when we get over there. And yes, I'm just using this truck here at the moment. I was kind of tabbing through looking for an actual truck and trailer to use. We didn't have any up in this region of the map, so it's like, hey, you know what? We just got these trucks sitting down here by the quarry. I'm just going to grab one of these. We don't have very far to go here, so didn't feel like dragging one up from the opposite end of the map over here. And we are heading down to National Gypsum. So like I said, we don't have too far to go here. And looks like that was all the gypsum. So yeah, okay, there is stone there yet, so we should be good. At least for a while yet. Also, plenty of limestone. If we ever need any more limestone, let's see what's here. National Gypsum. Oh, we need glue yet. Okay, never mind. We do need glue yet, so okay. And then hopefully we can kick off some drywall production. See if we have any glue ready to go or not, too. I'm not sure on that one. And we need the drywall so we can build the Pepsi factory. There actually might be some other factories that take it too, but I know Pepsi is in need of drywall so it can be finished being built. Okay, unload paper. Nope, gypsum is not accepted there. Unload glue there. Probably safe to say this is... Yep, nope, okay. Okay, where does the gypsum go then? I know there's a tip point on this side, but I think that's the pickup. Yep, nothing there. Like I said, I'm pretty sure that's the pickup there. Okay, I bet you it goes out here. Yep, there we go. It's always fun in some of these factories sometimes trying to find the different tip points that take the correct materials. Some of them, like the ones in there, are nice and labeled, you know, glue, paper. That's fairly easy to figure out, but the one outside there, not labeled. Okay, what's that one for? Well, process of elimination. That one right there in front of us, by the way, is coal. So that's where that goes, and again, that one's labeled, so that's kind of helpful. Which reminds me, folks, a couple people have been asking, how do you figure out what needs what on this map? Well, you got the menu system here, which at least for a US-based keyboard is pushing the question mark. The reason I say that, folks, I know some of the folks in the European countries with their European keyboards actually say it's different keys. So at least for a US-based keyboard, it is the question mark. And then from this list here, you know, pretty much whatever, you know, we're working on, like I said, Pepsi. And Pepsi needs drywall. So drywall is made at National Gypsum. They got drywall there. And yeah, as far as knowing what place makes what, if you don't know, either check the help menu or just go through the list here. There is a help file, PDF help file that comes with a map that is actually quite helpful. Lists most places that... Lists the places that actually build what they build, so... Okay, we got that. Let's check out user glue, which you can actually... We can do that from right here. We don't have to go anywhere. At least I think it was user glue. Yes, user glue makes glue. So it looks like they have a little bit there. Not a whole lot. Oh, and we got a license to cut down trees, too. Okay. Let's see, I think... Ooh, I'm not sure. Will this truck hold glue? Not sure on that. We'll find out. I might actually need the tanker for that. In which case, I'm going to have to go find a tanker somewhere. It's like we got how many of them around the map, but it's always trying to find them. That's always the fun part. And this is, I believe this is the Pepsi plant here. Yes, this is the Pepsi plant. Frito-Lay also needs to be built yet. So if we just pull in here, show you folks what we need. We need drywall. We currently have none. That's because the National Gypsum is not up and going yet. Been working on that lately. We still need some more steel and some more boards yet from the looks of it as well. That shouldn't be too big of a deal. I don't think. I know the steel plant's going. I don't know if it's all set or not, but it was going. Let's see what's here. That was crystal. Yeah, crystal steel. Oh, it looks like it probably needs some coal. Okay. Another good job for the ferry there, by the way. Okay, we'll head down to user glue. Oh, we got a tanker there. Okay, that's probably a good assumption. We need a tank for this then. Or actually, it might be a tank to bring the resin in. I'm not sure. We'll find out. So yeah, for some of these products, folks, there is a lot of steps involved to making this stuff, but it is pretty cool. We need to fill it. I think that was right here, wasn't it? We'll find out. Yep, we'll take glue. Interesting, we have line one and line two. Line two here says it takes fuel, so I'm assuming, you know, we got line one here is on coal, and if we bring some fuel up, we can actually get line two going. Don't know if this particular tank holds fuel, though. I don't think it does. There we go, 60,000 liters of glue. Oh boy, can you folks imagine that? Hauling around 60,000 liters of glue. Hate to spill that. Oh, bummer. I wanted to take a look at the license plates on the back here. I guess I can't do that. Actually, it should not be doing this to me. I thought I had the no collision camera mod on here, but apparently I don't. Or there's something wrong with it. It doesn't work multiplayer or something. For those of you who have not seen that mod, the no collision camera mod, pretty simple mod. What it does is it prevents this from happening. I'm not zooming in here. I'm just looking down, and it's just pulling me into the truck, clipping through stuff, or it's trying to prevent clipping through stuff, basically, which is kind of annoying. Unload. Okay, this is the next one, the glue. Yep, that one's a glue. And it's pretty cool, too. For you folks who have not seen this, you can actually see stuff appear. You know, on this side, we got the Cogent product, which I believe that's the paper. And then on this side, we got barrels of glue showing up. So it's pretty cool how stuff actually shows up when you deliver it places. And I can't even walk over there. Okay, that's interesting. But we should see a whole bunch more show up here once it's empty. And speaking of paper, it has just shy of 100,000. Paper is from the Cogent Forest products, by the way. Which there is. Oh, there's a bit more paper. I'm telling you, folks, this place burns through the wood chips like you would not believe. It's like, wow. I don't know how many wood chips we brought to this place, but it's just ridiculous. Yeah, for those of you who remember Pleasant Valley, we did a lot of forestry work on that server as well. So forestry definitely plays a heavy role in Pleasant Valley Rivers. But yeah, it makes it kind of fun though, because it actually has more of a purpose than just, say, selling the logs. You actually got a purpose for logs, you know, make paper, take the paper down to National Gypsum here, make drywall, bring the drywall down to Pepsi Factory, build a Pepsi Factory. And then, of course, once the Pepsi factory is built, it's going to need, I don't know what all it needs, but it's going to need a whole bunch of stuff so you can operate the Pepsi factory, of course. And as far as I know, folks, the ultimate goal on this map is to get the fair up and running. I don't know that there's really anything else beyond that. I know on Pleasant Valley there was the warehouse. That took us definitely the longest time to get going. And pretty much once we had the warehouse built too, it was like, okay, time to wrap it up, because that was like the last thing on that map. Okay, we'll just park this back here. And let's see, it needs resin. Yes, resin. I gotta remember where resin comes from again here. Oh, okay, that comes from the Cogent forest products as well. Okay, so that's probably why it's burning through so much wood chips. We're making boards, resin, and paper at the Cogent. Cogent's like working triple time there, apparently. Okay, so over to National Gypsum. It should have everything it needs right now, so we can kick off production. Yay, we got some drywall showing up. So we should probably get some more paper. Should definitely probably have some more glue. A little more gypsum probably won't hurt. I think we had some more paper here, didn't we? Not a whole lot, do we? Okay. We do have a bit of resin, though. Not doing too bad on the resin department here at the glue, though. We'll probably call that okay. So we should probably maybe go and cut some wood. That would probably be a good idea. Seeing how Cogent is, like, out of everything it needs to make everything we need. Not too worried about the boards, by the way. I think we got a lot of boards at the moment. Speaking of a lot of boards, we probably should, like, haul some down to the Pepsi factory here. Oh, let's see what we got. Well, we got a chipper. And, yeah, by the way, for you folks that remember Pleasant Valley, this map, and I was saying this to some of the other guys on the server here, this map seems like it's a whole lot easier than what Pleasant Valley was. We got a cheaty chipper here that makes chipping really easy. We got auto-loading trailers. We got conveyor belts. Didn't have any of that stuff back on Pleasant Valley. Did most of it all there manually. We did have the auto-loading trailers, but those were pretty much just a pain in the butt because they were always breaking down. Or the belts were always breaking down, so. Okay. Head over by boards here. See, I know we do need some boards for the Pepsi factory. We got a load of boards just sitting out in the middle of nowhere. That's kind of weird. Not sure what's up with that. Apparently only a partially full one, too. One go-kart in the mill pond. Not sure how it ended up down there, but so far I've just left it there. And please wait, folks, while we slowly walk over to the board factory here. Okay, what's up with the floating board over here? That's kind of weird. Yeah, it looks like they're both full, so we should probably get these unloaded. Okay, I was hoping there would be a forklift or something around here. The Volvo would work if it had forks on it. God, it looks like this. No, this is the log grapple, isn't it? Okay. Kind of useless. Okay, I'm gonna be able to tip it over. The only thing is, then what am I gonna be able to do with it? Because I still can't pick it up. We'll see if we can find the forklift here. Not sure where it's at. There always used to be one over here somewhere. Oh, maybe I can't tip it over either. There we go. Or if I can find a set of forks for the skid steer here, that won't be so bad. Let's see what's here. Oh, there's a forklift. Right there. Perfect. And what we can do, we can actually just push these out of the way. As long as we get them far enough away from the conveyor belt here so we don't break the conveyor belt. And I'm not really comfortable with this being that close to the conveyor belt here. It seems a little close. Let's move these farther away if we can. Push them on the other side of the railroad tracks. There we go. That'll be good. This view is actually really helpful for loading up the pallets. Okay, can't quite make the railroad tracks. Fine, I probably should really go with them that way. Actually, I can go this way. This seems how the truck is right here. That would probably make the most sense. Let's see, is the truck on? That's probably a no. That's the X for work position. Oh, let's change it to wood pallet. That would probably, there we go. I was going to say, that should be loading that. And yeah, folks, the reason I say you cannot unload the conveyor belt here with that truck, if you unload it with that truck, it will not detect that the pallets are gone. It'll still tell you, hey, you need to move the pallets, even though they are gone. So, yeah, unfortunately, a slight issue with that. Would be nice if they could get that bug fixed. So, you know, you could just take the truck here, drive faster, and boom, load it up just like that. Fortunately, you cannot do that, and I have lost my load. I'm not entirely sure how that happened, because that was in there pretty good, I thought. Okay, right. Gotta love them farm sim physics, folks. No way a pallet would do that in real life. At least a heavy one, anyway. Okay, what do we got? Two more on there yet, looks like. And then, of course, we got the other one that's full as well. And the Cogent, by the way, does have boards in it. They're not on pallets, though, I don't believe. You can just, like, use the box truck and load those up. Oh, the red light. Oh, there we go. Okay, I was going to say, the red light's on. That's not good. Now it's green. That means it's the conveyor belt can work. Okay, and as far as I know, this holds 8, so we can put one more on there yet. Oh, you know what? We got one right over here. Perfect. One we tipped over here just a couple minutes ago. Okay. That's weird. You know, we'll just leave it there. That should be far enough away from any conveyor belts. We can just drive past for the truck. And actually, we should probably leave the... Okay, we'll leave that there. Perfect. And there we go, perfect. And by the way, there is a storage point for boards as well. That should be this building right over here. You can either store the building, the boards in there, in this building, or you could take them directly to where you need them. I think we'll probably just take them directly to where we need them. I'm not sure which way holds more, if we can hold more with this or with the tractor trailer there. The 53-foot trailer. I'll probably do that off-screen, though, because that'll be a bit of driving. And we'll just head out to the Pepsi plant. Yes, like I said, you could unload the boards there. And then you can use the other type of trailer, pickup boards. The only issue I've had is that trailer, sometimes it doesn't seem like the trigger points actually will accept those boards. Don't know why. But I have had issue with that. I have not had an issue with it taking boards like this, though. Never had an issue with it taking the pallet boards. But if you bring them down with the box trailer, then it seems like sometimes I've had issues with it taking those boards. Don't know why, but sometimes it won't take those type of boards for some reason. And let's just see what type of shape these board makers are in. Oh, I got a bit of logs. Not a lot, but a bit. And not being too far from the forest here, we could probably just cut a couple trees down and push them over rather than having to load them up. That board sitting up there, folks, might be an issue where someone drove past with a truck and trailer there, picked up the board pallets that were underneath of it, and because it did not detect that those are gone, it's still floating there. That might be what happened with that pallet that's sitting up in the air there. It's basically the same type of thing that happens with the conveyor belts here. If you pick them up with that trailer, you auto-load them. It will not detect that the pallets are gone, and it will still think it's full, and therefore pretty much shut down your board production. And the only way to fix it is to restart the server. Which, you know, not the end of the world, just kind of a pain. You have to restart the server every now and then. Seems like we've been doing a pretty good job lately. Have not had to restart the server lately because of it. I know we have a couple of times in the past because the palletized items quit working. And there's more than just the boards here as well. There's blocks, there's pallets. There's probably some other stuff too. But all that will stop working if you use the auto-loading trailer there. Yeah, if you unload it with the forklift here first, should be fine. I've never had an issue yet where it quits working if you do it with this. Okay, a couple more pallets to go. Actually, looks like we should get another full load here. We got four, and then we got another four. That'll be perfect for another load of eight pallets of wood. Just see if we can get this one that's floating up in the air here a minute. I suspect if we bump it in any way, it'll probably fall down. Just a guess. Oh, yeah, what did I tell you, folks? Bump it, and it fell down. So, yeah, I'm guessing someone probably had it stacked up here, and then they maybe drove past with the auto-loading trailer, pulled out the ones from underneath of it, didn't detect that they're gone, and, yeah, stayed floating in the air. Oops, they're a little too low there. It is cool, by the way, to watch some of these factories work and all the animations that went into some of these factories. That is pretty cool. Especially for those of you who have not seen the block factory. Kind of cool how they've done that with the loading of the material for it. Maybe we get this last one off here. Maybe we'll just tab over there quick a minute if there's something over there to tab to anyway. And I can show you folks what I'm talking about. Okay, we'll get the last one off here a minute. Okay, there we go. That should be a nice, safe place to auto-load them from. You could drive them all the way over to the storage facility there, too, by the way, but probably a little bit easier just to do it this way. Okay, folks, like I said, before we wrap up the episode, oh, good, we do have something over here, the Block Factory. This is another one of those unlabeled locations on the map, by the way. So, for those of you wondering where it is, down by Field 38 here, kind of annoying that it's not labeled. Speaking of which, how is it doing? That looks like it has everything it needs. I don't know that we necessarily need blocks for anything. We probably do for some more fruit farms. But anyway, this is what I was talking about, folks. Kind of a cool loading mechanic here. You can see it's going to do the gravel. And it's going to swing all the way over into the stone, I think. Yes, it's going to do the stone. It's going to do the sand. Yeah, just kind of cool how the mod author got it animated like that. And then if we go back inside. Oh, I said inside. That was weird. We can go around this way. You can see all the stuff coming in there. Like I said, the mod author did a nice job of animating all this stuff. Oh, looks like we got tipped over block pallet there. Anyway, folks, with that, I think we need to wrap up the episode there. If folks have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. And as always, thanks for watching and until next time.